Let's try to figure out the derivative of e to the negative x. So previously, we've learned that the derivative of e to the x equals e to the x. But here we have e to the negative x, which is quite different. So we can't use the same rule to take its derivative. But actually what we can do to try and figure out the form of this derivative is use the quotient rule that we just learned. So let me remind you of the formula for the quotient rule. So it goes like this. The derivative with respect to x of f of x over g of x equals g of x f prime of x minus f of x g prime of x all over g of x quantity squared. Or you can remember it, bottom times the derivative of the top minus top times the derivative of the bottom over the bottom squared. So e to the negative x doesn't look like a product. Sorry, it doesn't look like a quotient. So you might be thinking, why are we going to use the quotient rule on e to the negative x? Well, actually, e to the negative x can be written as a quotient if you remember your rules of exponents. So remember that a negative exponent can be made positive if you move it to the denominator. So, in other words, the derivative of e to the negative x, I can write that as the derivative of 1 over e to the x using exponent rules. So these are really useful rules to remember and be able to use. Okay, so now I actually do have a quotient, 1 over e to the x. So let's apply the quotient rule to this function. Okay, so g of x f prime of x. That's the first part. So that's going to be e of x times the derivative of 1 minus f of x g prime of x. That's top times the derivative of the bottom. So 1 times the derivative of e to the x all over the bottom squared, e to the x quantity squared. Okay, so let's do a little bit more work in the numerator. So this equals e to the x times the derivative of 1, and that's 0, minus 1 times the derivative of e to the x, and that's e to the x, all over e to the x quantity squared. Okay, and then what? Well, e to the x times 0 is just 0, minus 1 times e to the x, so I end up with negative e to the x over e to the x squared. Now this is something I can reduce because I have one factor of e to the x on top, two factors on the bottom. So I'm going to reduce this to negative 1 over e to the x. So that's my answer. Now what I can do to make this look a little bit more like the original form is actually move that e to the x back up into the numerator by making the exponent negative again. So in other words, this is equivalent to negative e to the negative x. So the derivative with respect to x of e to the negative x equals negative e to the negative x. You'll use this derivative a lot, so it's good just to remember it in of itself, but remember that you can derive it using the quotient rule.